In this video, we'll learn another way to say the degree to which an action happens. Compared to the previous videos, this way of saying is more common in daily conversations. You'll be able to say, "He drives fast," in a more colloquial way. Hi everyone, welcome to Learn Mandarin Grammar with Xu Laoshi. I know learning grammar can be tedious when learning a foreign language, but it's one of the fastest ways to improve your proficiency level. You'll be able to make higher level conversations and dramatically improve your writing skill. So let's get to it. I'll start with a series of examples to demonstrate the usage. Then I'll explain the grammatical points in detail. After that, we'll see how it applies to the examples. At the end, we'll conclude with a practice question to see if you have mastered the concept. So far, we've learned two ways to express the degree to which an action happens. One is when the verb doesn't have an object, and the other one is when the verb has an object. I've linked those two videos in the description section below, so you can check it out if you missed it. In this video, we'll learn another way to say it when the verb has an object. It's also a more colloquial way to say. Let's look at the examples first. Instead of saying 他看YouTube看得很开心, you can say 他YouTube看得很开心。他YouTube看得很开心。 Instead of saying 他做饺子做得很好, you can say 他饺子做得很好。他饺子做得很好。 Instead of saying 他开车开得很快, you can say 他车开得很快。 他车开得很快. Instead of saying 他打篮球打得不好, you can say 他篮球打得不好。他篮球打得不好. Instead of saying 你说中文说得非常好, you can say 你中文说得非常好。你中文说得非常好. In the past videos, we learned when we want to say the degree to which an action happens, we use the structure of subject, verb, object, verb, the complement. Note that this structure only applies to the case when the verb is followed by an object. And since the object and the complement don't share a single verb, we have to give each of them a verb to follow. For example, 你说中文说得非常好. You speak Mandarin Chinese very well. Here we have to repeat the verb 说 because 中文, the object, and 非常好, the degree complement, don't share a single verb 说. However, this is not the only way to say it. Another way to say is to simply drop the first verb and put only the object in the front. So the structure is subject, object, verb, the complement. For example, 你中文说得非常好. You speak Mandarin Chinese very well. Now, let's see how this structure is used in the examples. 他YouTube看得很开心. He watches YouTube very happily. 他YouTube看得很开心. 他饺子做得很好. He makes dumpling very well. 他饺子做得很好. 他车开得很快. He drives very fast. 他车开得很快。他篮球打得不好. He doesn't play basketball well. 他篮球打得不好。你中文说得非常好. You speak Chinese very well. 你中文说得非常好. Now let's practice. Rearrange the following words to say he sings very well. You have 10 seconds starting now. 嘿, time's up. The answer is 他歌唱得很好. This is a take-home practice. How would you say the following sentence? The plane is flying very high. Do it yourself first, and you can check the answer in the description section below. As an additional practice, you can also use the structure to make a sentence of your own and post it in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. I hope this video was helpful. If you like this video, please hit the like button and share it with your friends who you think may benefit from it. Also, come to my channel and see if there is anything else you like. If you have any questions, you can ask in the comment section below. I know learning Mandarin is hard, but don't lose heart. You can do it. I'll see you in the next video. 再见。